What our special issue shows is that we can have and we need novel policy making, novel policy solutions.
We are faced today with a new challenge, which results from the combination of jobless economic growth, the rising human productivity, and the increase of the available labor pool across the world.
We're also witnessing a period of challenges to multilateralism. There are various key global governance actors retreating from global governance processes.
Évidemment, ce n'est pas spécifique à l'OIT, mais se pose la question de savoir si le mode de fonctionnement tripartiste qui a fait l'histoire de l'OIT demeure un mode de fonctionnement pertinent, efficace.
The papers speak to each other in interesting ways. The journal weaves them together to get a sense of how the ILO has had to take on board and adapt.
The reality of the African continent is that there are a lot more people in the informal sector, and it's increasing. The ILO has managed very beautifully to metamorphose and align its vision with the changing local context.
There is a forum there which can be used to advance situations like the structural violence of migrant workers.
L'OIT a aussi, depuis ses débuts, beaucoup travaillé sur des questions de genre dans l'agriculture. Sur tous ces domaines dans lesquels l'OIT travaille, c'est extrêmement important que la question de l'organisation de la reproduction sociale soit repensée afin d'alléger ce travail et de mieux le répartir.
The ILO's positioning as a global body can really help to connect conversations about the way in which dialogue changes, the way in which consensus is reached, the kind of failures and dynamics that lead to obstacles.
So our special issue was looking at all these issues, learning from the past and trying to figure out how the ILO could remain relevant and what are the major issues looming in terms of the future of work.